In this video, we will follow our documentation article on integrating the Web Report Designer in an ASP.NET Core 5 web application. Let's copy the name of the first required NuGet package, which we will add to the project later. It will include the rest of the packages in the list, as this one package depends on the rest of them. Let's create an empty ASP.NET Core 5 web application. I will disable the HTTPS as it requires a valid certificate, and if we don't have one assigned to the corresponding domain, the application will fail to run. Next, we need to find the package, which name we copied earlier, in the NuGet package manager. You need to have the package manager configured to access the Telerik private NuGet feed with your own credentials. We install the package, and by clicking accept, it will also install its dependencies. Let's assure that the required Telerik reporting packages has been successfully added. Now we need to configure the required services in the startup file of the application. We need to add the Web API controllers and enable Newtonsoft JSON serialization. Then, let's map the controllers. And enable serving of static files. Now we need to configure the Telerik Reporting REST service and the Telerik Report Designer REST service. Let's paste the code from the documentation article. As we're going to use the default appsettings.json configuration file, we may change the report engine configuration to read the default configuration. Through the quick actions and refactorings option, the needed using directives can be added to fix the errors for unresolved references. Don't forget to add the connection string and the other necessary reporting configuration in the appsettings.json file. Next, we need to add our controllers. For this purpose, we create the controllers folder. Inside this folder, add an empty API controller that we name Report Designer Controller. We can copy the code from the documentation article into the controller. We are ready to test the Report Designer's REST service. Let's build the application and go to the specified test URL. It seemed to be returning the expected response. It is time to add the reports we are going to open with the designer. We have already set up the report definition storage to the reports folder of the application. So let's add reports to it. The dashboard report connects to a database so that we can make sure that the configuration in the appsettings.json file gets respected. Now we can also add the index.html page that would host our web report designer. Again, we can copy over the code from the documentation article. It references one of the reports we just added to the report definition storage. Let's make the page with the designer the default launch page. We are ready to test the web report designer. It opens the default report with no issues. It also finds and is able to open the second report we copied over to the storage. The design time data is displayed on the graph. Hence, the connection string is read from the configuration, and everything is working as expected.